it is time to move on to our speaking portion. And in this case, Yash will be presenting. Yash is a new member, and this is his second speech, which I was very sorry that I had to miss the first, so I'm very happy that I'm here today. In his researching and presenting project for his presentation mastery path, Yash will cover the origin, philosophy, and parts of Ashtanga Yoga. I'm excited for this because I have spent a fair amount of time practicing yoga over the years, and in true American form, I have not really taken the time to learn about the deep origins and philosophy. Thank you, Yash, for presenting your speech entitled Yoga in a Nutshell. Yash?
Looking at this weird pose and chanting, one can very easily come to a conclusion, right? That yoga, the word yoga, is a synonym for circus. Because of the animal lovers protesting nowadays, they cannot make these animals to do weird things. That's why they are asking human beings to do these kind of things, because there are no lovers to human beings. So it is okay to do that, right? That's all we are thinking. I see Hemang nodding his Indian style. No. So then there should be something else to yoga, right? Then what is the yoga? I looked at it a couple of places, like Kate did. I came to know that yoga, a Sanskrit word, meaning union or yoke. Union? What is that union? Union of what? Then I also knew, came to know that it is a union of lower self with higher self. What is that lower self or lower soul? Is nothing but our body, mind, and the consciousness to experience the oneness with the Almighty or the higher soul. That is yoga. If that is yoga, why we should do that? We should do that to experience the highest bliss or the highest possible happiness. When we experience the oneness with the Almighty or the higher soul, it is happiness every time, everywhere. It is self-realization, or we also call enlightenment. That's why we need to practice that. So how to do that? The Indian sages, since long time, around 4,000 years ago, they came up with some techniques to do that. And around 2nd century BC, a sage called Patanjali, he formulated called Yoga Sutras or formulae to experience the oneness with God, Almighty, or self-realization, whatever you call it. So those are called the 8-stepped process called Ashtanga Yoga. So people, whatever we see here in yoga studios and all, it is to do with just one part of those 8 steps, which is called asana. But it is a step-by-step process of achieving the enlightenment or experiencing the oneness with the God. Those 8 steps are yama, niyama, asana, pranayama, pratyahara, dharana, dhyana, and samadhi. No, I am not talking in my mother tongue. And these are the Sanskrit words. Yama and niyama, abstinence and observances, are, there are 10, like your 10 commandments. So five each, yama and niyama. The first five talks about what we should not do. And the other five talks about what we should do. The first one are called satya, asteya, ahimsa, aparigraha, and brahmacharya. Basically, they talk about don't steal, don't lie, observe non-violence, you know, don't get into too much of pleasurely things, things like that. And the second part, niyama, I mentioned, it is called shaucha, santosha, swadhyaya, and ishvari pranidhana. That means be contentful and be pure, and also read good books like philosophical books, do good deeds. And the last one, Ishvara Pranidhana, is whatever you receive as a result of doing good deeds, you present that to that it is a boon from the Almighty. So those are the first 10 ones. Then everyone knows about asana part, the poses, a sound mind in a sound body, right? Just based on that, if your body is fit, then you can concentrate, your mind concentrates well on doing dhyana and other things. The next one is the systematic breathing, pranayama, control of your prana, or in relative terms, breathing. Then comes the pratyahara. Pratyahara is actually withdrawal from senses that do not, instead of extrovert, you be introvert, thinking, so that you can concentrate, called dharana. Concentrate on one thing. The yogis normally concentrate on the chakras, the energy centers on our body. They concentrate normally on Ajna Chakra, which is the third eye location, or Mooladhara Chakra, and couple other chakras. These are called energy center. Then dhyana is meditation, obviously. Samadhi, the last stage is the highest stage of yogic practice, that is the experiencing the oneness with the Almighty. With that being said, the yoga is not just for the physical health of a practitioner. It is to do with the ethical health of the practitioner, obviously physical health, and the health of our mind, and the spiritual health of the practitioner as well. By achieving all this, the one will experience the overall health of the society, of a nation, or the universe is achieved. That is the essence of yoga is. And when time permits, probably we can expand each of these ashtangas in detail. Thank you very much for the opportunity.
Thank you so much, Yash. I really appreciated learning more about this practice that I have enjoyed over the years. So I appreciate you bringing this to us today.